Right now, let me move to the third point, because 1 and 3 really need to be thought of in unison. So I hope at this point you understand, at least at a conceptual level, how we are able to minimize collisions and adapt the contention parameters in a way that maximizes throughput within a particular access point. So now you have two access points that are on the same channel and hear each other. Well, each access point is advertising its own values, right, to its own devices. And the challenge here is to figure out how these access points pick values so that these two transmissions, which might potentially collide with each other, don't go on at the same time. Now, notice, this is very important. We are not saying that any two of these transmissions cannot happen at the same time. That's a very important distinction. The network knows if these two transmissions do not collide with each other, in other words, the signal-to-noise ratio is good. Even, in fact, if these two APs hear each other, we will enable those transmissions. As I said, in a separate video, we'll discuss how we do that. For now, let us assume that all of these links are essentially colliding with each other. So let me draw with the help of a graph. Let me try to explain how that works. I'm going to erase all of this, just leaving the top level points. So the idea is the following. So I have four access points. I have a bunch of devices, right? Now notice that from the device perspective, they don't know the presence of all the four access points. They're just talking, right? So what we do is every access point essentially acts as an air monitor. So we have this graph. And what does this graph say? This graph is essentially a reachability graph where I know this device is visible to two access points. And of course, with each of these, we'll correspondingly have the RSSIs, the signal quality, the number of packets received, and all of that. So notice that the controller, or globally, we have this picture of the air. And we also know which access points are interfering with each other. Now, ideally, it would be nice to know which stations are also interfering with each other. But that's some information that's not available to us. So this is the picture we have. Now, you can superimpose on this the associations, right? Or what we think of as assignments, because of course in our network, a station associates with the network. But let's assume that in the infrastructure, we happen to assign these three devices to this access point, this device to this access point, and these three devices to this access point. Yeah? Now notice that the reds tell you the actual assignments, how traffic goes. The purple lines, in addition, tell you where all the interferences are. Now, it's pretty easy to see conceptually how you would extend everything that I've said so far into this multi-AP architecture. In the previous concept, we were only looking at the red graph with respect to one access point. So if you pick this AP only cares about these three links in the previous graph, right? Because there were three contenders, and we wanted to minimize contention within this particular AP. Now you want to step back and you say this AP sees all of these other transmissions and it knows, for example, that this particular link and this particular link will not, actually, these two links will collide with each other because of this AP to AP. Right? Why is that? For this AP, this link, this red link to transmit, whether uplink or downlink, let's say in this particular case uplink, you have a transmission followed by an acknowledgement. Or if it's downlink, you have a downlink transmission followed by an ACK. So one important thing is 802.11 is commutative. Every data transmission requires a two-way handshake. And likewise, you have a two-way handshake here. And notice that at this point, we've drawn these interferences or these links such that you cannot have simultaneous transmission. We've ignored channel reuse for this discussion. So these two transmissions cannot go on at the same time because these links are colliding. So essentially, you think about it as a graph here where up to a degree 2, in other words, up to a distance 2 from any two edges, those transmissions cannot happen simultaneously. Specifically, this link, and this link can transmit simultaneously, but this one and this one cannot. So essentially, think about it as not a node-based interference, but a link-based interference, where we see which links are able to transmit simultaneously. Now, notice that in terms of what we advertise, we can only advertise contention parameters, right? Those are the levers that we have. So what do we do? Within an access point, now bringing it down to the physical level, let me use a purple pen here so it's easier to see. Within an access point, I have some number of devices, but then I have a whole bunch of other APs that I interfere with. What I'm going to do is try to abstract out all of this additional traffic as other devices here. So from a single APs view, what I'm going to do is to say, here are all the devices I have. And oh, by the way, here is one composite device that is interfering with me. And I'm going to try to figure out what my contention parameter needs to be based on all my uplink and downlink for each of these devices, plus a set of uplink and downlink, which is really a composite of all the other traffic surrounding me. So if you have two access points, one that has, let's say, all data transmission, but a neighbor has voice transmission, because we have this global knowledge, we know that these two APs will interfere with each other, and there is, in fact, this overlap of voice traffic with data traffic, and therefore we can adapt the parameters appropriately. Or if it turns out that I have only one device connected to my AP, but my neighbor has 100 devices, and all of these are interfering with my transmission, then I'll really think of it as 101 devices, not one device. And the way this information is captured is because all of these access points are periodically transmitting their overall load to a central controller, which has this global data, on which basis it can figure out the actual contention over the air, on which basis we apply the same mechanisms as before, and in fact figure out how we can come up with contention parameters that take into account overall interference in a region as opposed to what happens within a single access point. Hope this makes sense. If we get this right, we will be able to cap the amount of collisions, which is something that we actually see relative to pretty much every other player in the industry. And once you cap the collisions, notice that you've taken out the most significant cause of loss or degradation of utilization in the channel, and that's what allows us to maximize channel utilization. Thank you.